Hey gang, I'm back here with the pod. This is a show. It's an internet, youtube.com. It's an internet program that I do. I talk on the ride while I'm driving.
Fucking ace! Fuck!
Sorry, I had some seatbelt issues. There you go. Excuse me. Just drinking some water. Trying to stay hydrated. For the opening 53 seconds or so of this. This is Vernon Hell's Drive Time multimedia program. I have to be honest with you, I've been playing a character for the beginning of the show. I'm actually in a really good mood today. I was trying to come off like I was annoyed by things. Not the case. I feel pretty good. Monday. It's a Monday. It's sunny. It was shitty out this morning. Rain kind of broke. Still really hot, but not crazy hot. It's like 80. Probably like 80 degrees. Not super humid. Definitely like blue skies. So, you know, that hazy summer oppression with constant threat of thunder showers is... I mean, I'm sure it'll be back tomorrow like it always is, but so far so good. Passing the Exxon station now. I guess what I've never done, I've done a lot of these talk shows now. Note on the guest situation. I sent out a few Craigslist flyers, and like I don't, and A, no one really, I didn't get back any serious responses, but B, also B, I did not ever even hook up stopping at my favorite spot in the road here where there's people leave stuff, so hold on, I think there's some DVDs. Oh my god. There's an Under Siege on DVD right now. I'm getting Under Siege. There's a DVD of Under Siege. And a Stallone movie called Cobra. And Meet Joe Black. All on DVD. And they have Schindler's List on VHS. I don't want to... This is stuff they could probably use. So I don't really want to go crazy taking this stuff. I'm not going to take any of the tapes. Alright, I'm just gonna take Under Siege. I'm taking Under Siege with Steven Seagal, the DVD. I sent my mom back in my car. I feel okay. I feel a little dirty for doing that because they could have sold that for like a dollar for charity. I think that's what they do here. That's still very unclear. But that's a perfectly good copy of Under Siege on DVD. Quick note on the DVDs, I am not a Blu-ray guy, so I don't have Blu-ray technology. I'm not even sure I've ever actually watched a Blu-ray. I probably have at somebody's house. That's something, as I've gotten older, you have less friends that you see, I guess, inevitably. So that is a factor in this. But the sitting and watching a movie on the DVD at least in my circle, I have to say, it's become something of a lost art. I guess not an art, but, you know, just a lost pastime. a thing that you can do for fun. And it's a shame, too, because I've built up my DVD collection through various means in the last year, especially, I would say, downloading some stuff and burning to actual DVDs, because I'm not savvy enough with the technology to hook up the laptop feed to the flat screen. I have a very modest flat screen, like 30-inch or something, Sharp brand. It was I bought like three or four years ago. That, you know, it's fine. I'm not a gearhead in any fashion. Like, I don't. I mean, I like the obviously the iPhone. I feel like that is the when I got that, it was a very it took a minute. But then I was like, yeah, this felt right. This was an extension of my being, almost. So it was almost like bigger than technology, in terms of the creative potential that one could use it as a tool to do other things and for other projects, just as a as an aid, not as the not as the ends. But the ends, as far as other stuff like pro speakers and entertainment centers and that kind of thing, I'm really am not. And and just even recording technique and style of microphones and from a musical standpoint. As a musician, from both as a listener and as a musician, and as a someone who takes in culture and all its multimedia, all the formats of multimedia, I'm not someone who has ever been concerned with the latest and the greatest. I think they did a good job with the DVDs. I think that technology works really well, and like, I'm happy with my pretty decent DVD collection. I got a lot of obscure movies that I have downloaded and also burned onto a DVD, and I've also checked and made sure they work with my DVD player. My DVD player is also it also still does the VHS, and that's more of a novelty. I don't think I've ever used it except to watch like home videos, but I have a couple like tapes. I have a tape of It's a Wonderful Life. I can watch during Christmas time if I feel like it. And I got a pretty good selection of old, like, taped off of TV movies and things like that from, just when I was a kid. So I've kept a lot of that stuff, and I want to really reorganize it. And, I understand that VHS has a shelf life, and I do want to get around to, digitalizing some of the things that I want to definitely get digitalized. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, so, I mean, yeah, I think there's just good and bad to a lot of everyone's. Like, the Blu-ray, it's, okay, I look at a Blu-ray, and I'm like, well, that looks like a DVD. Like, if I'm gonna seriously think about upgrading, and you're gonna hand me something that's, like, looked exactly like the older one, like, what do I do with this? Like, this looks like a DVD. It just says Blu-ray instead of DVD. And there's a Blu-ray logo instead of a DVD logo. I don't get it. Obviously, like, from Laserdisc to DVD, that was, like, a cooler jump because they compacted it and it got smaller. Right? And, cassettes don't look like CDs. So you had cassettes to CDs. That was a pretty big fucking jump. Like, what is the next thing after CDs? I mean, obviously we're in the digital landscape now, and so they can sell, like, hard drives and little chips and have all this data compressed, like, tons of albums worth of data. That's why this is for another episode, so maybe I can try and branch off of this, because I'm home right now, so I'm definitely done.